Hi, hello. We are going to start our live within a few minutes, and we are waiting for Sindhil sir to join us. So once he's there, we are going to start our physio conversation with Sindhil sir. So let's all our physio friends join. So, if you are willing to ask any question to the guest of today's live session, you can comment so that we can ask him at the last or in between the session. Yeah, hi, 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 Nawaz. Hello, Evangeline. Thank you for joining live, and thank you, Tina Singh. Akshay, thank you for joining the live session. We are going to begin in a while, so we are waiting for sir to join actually at 5 o'clock. So, and if you want to ask something, so you can type in the comment section. So sir has joined. Sir, you can send me a request, sir, to join so that. Yeah, Akshay, we'll bring it on. Yeah, we'll ask to, sir. Yes. Sir, welcome to Physio Conversations, sir. So, thank you for accepting our invitation and being among us. Thank you, sir. Welcome.
Okay. So it's always nice to meet people, especially during lockdown.
You have been setting records in the lockdown session by securing an ISO certification as well as setting one your second OMPT conference and having an affiliation with the Journal of Manipulative Therapy. So you have been doing good. So, and we convey our best wishes to you, sir.
Definitely. Your words mean a lot. Because I'll tell you the truth.
Sir?
This is the first time officially I'm interviewing.
Okay, sir. It's thank you for giving this opportunity. Sir, this is going to be somewhat a professional interview where we are not going to ask any personal questions, where we are not going to put you under trouble. One thing is, you have such a lot of experience in this profession where we can learn something, because your experience is a lesson for all the upcoming and the younger generation of physios. So if you could tell something about your life experience, and then if that would benefit our physio friends, that would be a great, sir. So let's, without any delay, let's start the physio conversation. So first thing is, sir, first, let's begin with your schooling days, sir. So where did you start your schooling? 10 plus inter plus 2 and then your BPT, please. Because these are not available anywhere unless and until you tell that. So yeah, sir.
I was trying
to. You said
you're not going to ask me
ask
personal.
Me personal. Sir, this is personal in the
starting
sense, what is
the
bank
childhood. No, I had the black balance is not a problem. I can say container and containers of best wishes.
Best wishes. Yeah.
And the prayers and blessings of elders. Blessings of elders. A lot of hope from juniors. When they listen to my name and they look at me, trust me. So more than that, I don't need a balance in the bank. Okay.
Yeah, sir.
And
please
yeah.
Do tell us
and
about your schooling, sir.
Early years, yeah. Early years, I have actually I'm born from Salem, Tamil Nadu. And then I got shifted to Chennai. So I did my early schooling, from Prince Matriculation High Secondary School, Chennai. And then Vanwani Matriculation within the IIT campus. So I completed my 10th and plus 2 from Anwani. And then afterwards the bachelor's. I joined after attending the counseling, his government seat. Almost all the colleges have got filled. And I got a private college. There was only two colleges left that day. And my mother was the one who was insisting that don't waste 1 year. Okay. You have to join physiotherapy. You join any profession, but you join. Okay. I was not interested. I was telling that I again. Okay, because I was actually into engineering. I wanted to do the IIT.
Hello.
Yeah, and after that, I realized that engineering did not like me the way I liked it. I'm not able to. Okay, you are able to hear me?
Saying that my voice is echoing, so I'm trying to connect it.
Yeah, correct. Because of the microphone, double your speaker sound is also coming in the microphone. Okay, the dual sound. Yeah, now it's perfect. It's fine.
Hello? Sir, can you speak, sir, now?
Yeah, it's fine. You're able to hear me? You're not able to hear me?
No, sir, no, sir. These are some technical glitches, actually. Just a minute, sir.
Are you hearing me? Can you hear me? No, you are not audible. Dr. Srinivas.
It's connected actually, but I cannot hear
you. Yeah, now you are audible. Now you are audible. Yeah.
Okay, but your voice is not audible to me, sir. That's it.
Earlier it was audible.
Earlier it was on this thing actually. Now you speak, sir. Hello?
Yeah. Now is it audible?
Yeah, sir. Yeah. Now I am able to hear only little.
So then we'll have without your earphone.
Yeah, sir. Yeah. Now I think without earphone is only better. Yeah. Okay. Sir, so your mother's wish was to get into medicine and your wish was to go into engineering.
She do not want me to waste 1 year. Okay. Basically, she didn't want me to waste 1 year. And she said, whatever you take it, you do well.
Okay.
She brought the application form for physiotherapy like in the last moment. And she said one of her colleagues' son is also applying. So you just try. I gave it application for B-Pharm also and BPT.
Okay.
And the counseling day was very lengthy. So I didn't want to stay there. I wanted to leave the place. My mom was insisting that you have come here, we should attend the counseling and go. Okay. And then there are two colleges which were available. One which was near my house.
This was in which year, sir? This was in which year?
1996.
Okay.
Okay. So, and then afterwards it is like, I chose the college which was far away. Okay. So, I don't know what made me to choose that, but I choose that. Okay. Mainly, I was having a cycle. Okay. Bicycle. I used to ride with that. I wanted a bike. Okay. So, I thought if I choose a college which is far away, I'll get a bike. Okay. So, and that's the reason why I choose that college. And I was not very sure whether I'll join there or not. Okay. And we came back from the counseling. Then finally, mom told that, yes, you are going to join. I didn't want to go by the cycle. I was asking her for the bike. So I had my own hesitations to start the BPT as a program. And then she fixed the college bus. So college bus will come. I will get in very easy from the house, walkable distance. Then I go like that. And finally, college was, there was nothing big in the eventful in the sense. Okay. Now my present BS college, it is Bharani Swati College of Physiotherapy, the 96 batch I was. And we were the fourth batch in that college. And now the college was closed 4 or 5 years after we completed the BPT. Okay. It was like sort of a temporary establishment. They had the college and the college disappeared. Okay, sold to somebody like that. But it was under the Tamil Nadu Dr. MGR Medical University. And it was a 3.5 years BPT. So,
okay.
3 years till 99. And then 99 from February to August was the internship. And we completed and got graduated from as a BPT. Okay, the last 3.5 year batch of Tamil Nadu Dr. MGR Medical University. It was.
Okay. So, it was not the nomenclature of the BPT was Bachelor's in Physiotherapy. It was not BSc Honours, nothing like that.
Nothing like that. It was BPT only. Okay, Bachelor of Physiotherapy.
So, sir, you were not knowing much thing about the physiotherapy, and then when you entered and when the classes were going on, how did you find the course it to be, sir? You wanted to pursue it, or what was going through your mind, whether this is what you wanted or it was destined to be in the physiotherapy? What was going through, and then how did you develop that love towards the profession?
Good question. You use the real word love. My love only created the, what to say is, I actually first had love. Okay.
Yeah,
that was typically how college boys develop towards girls. Okay. I had one girl who was very, you know, impressive for me. And guys also, everyone in groups, they were all making fun. And I don't know whether I really loved her. But she asked me that, do you love me? Okay. When a girl comes and asks whether you love me, okay, well, how can a boy tell that I don't love you? Okay, it's impossible. and you always feel that she is loving me. That's why she is asking, okay, this is the moment. Okay. So I said, yes, I love you. And immediately she went around everywhere and then she finally rejected me. Okay. That's the truth. So the failure of the college typical experience of whatever love made me to realize that what, and I was just wondering, she rejected, she was telling some parents all these reasons. Okay. She's also, now also she is a physio, she is in Chennai. That's not my first love. Okay. There is long, so many times before that there is love. Okay. So, but that is college first experience. So, and after a few months, I saw her that she is actually going around with one of my senior, okay, who looks more handsome, more smart, okay. And then I realized that, oh, she rejected me because I am not up to that level, okay, something like that she would have felt. So now I have to prove what my level is, okay. So I converted that grief of the failure into an energy for performance, okay, through my anger. Okay, I positively directed my anger towards her, and then what I did was, I have to prove a point, okay, that I am the best in the college, in the batch, okay, so that she will turn towards me, her attention will come to me, okay, so like that. And then subsequently in the anatomy, we always need a good teacher, okay, a great teacher to create the turning point. And we had one teacher, Dr. Mani Meghalai. She was working at SRM College and she had got her visa to go to US. But there was some delay in her processing and she was there in India, supposed to be for 6 months or something. So in between, she didn't want to be idle. So she came to our college and she started teaching anatomy. She hardly took classes for us 2 to 3 weeks. After that, madam left the college and went. Okay, because she has to leave for US. And that madam, you can't believe, first day she's coming to the anatomy class. Okay, already the bones are arranged. We usually see the bones only during the practical viva. But she kept all the bones on the table there before only. Some students have kept it. And after that, she came with a lot of color chalk pieces. Okay. And she started drawing the scapula. In different dimensions, the attachments, origin, insertion, how you see red and blue, the colors in the bone, origin, insertion, same way she drew it. She drew it very fast. I was absolutely admiring that. Oh my goodness. Because I had my hobby to paint. Okay? I have done some sketches before during my, from my childhood. So I was fascinated to see that the diagram, okay, the anatomy, human body. So that was my link. And then once anatomy, there was a grip. Moment any physical therapist, I'll tell you, any student, if you want to really feel that you are a doctor, you are in a medical profession, if you develop a passion towards anatomy, you will clear it in flying colors. Okay? There is no doubt about it. In fact, the knowledge of anatomy helped me in physiology also. Okay, I did not know anything about physiology those days. And I didn't want to give the university exam, physiology. My mother told me that you have to give the exam. I know you will be successful. Don't come out of the hall very fast. Stay till the full 3 hours. Whatever you know, you write in the paper. Just to fill it and come. And every physiology question, I was writing anatomy. And I cleared. Okay. And after that, the second semester it was. First semester was psychology and sociology. Second semester was anatomy and physiology. First semester I was a typical college boy. Okay. All this having fun with people, going around, ragging. Okay. Some of the friendly seniors who are helping out, laughing at our own friends who are being ragged. Okay. Everything was happening. And then next one, the third one was, we had the exercise therapy, electrotherapy, all that. Once the therapeutic thing came, immediately I switched on to that competition. Okay, I have to be the topper. Okay, after anatomy, and anatomy helped me in physiology. So, and I used to draw diagrams. I was anatomy topper, okay, in my class, okay, in that second semester. So that made me to realize that I can also be a topper. Okay, and I could get that revenge, okay, on that person who rejected me. Okay, so I was like more into doing more sincerely, working, exercise, electro and all that. And it actually paid off that I was topper in the third, fourth semester biomechanics came. Further, it got multiplied. And then afterwards, it went on to clinical neuro, clinical conditions in the fifth. And sixth is the PT. All semesters, I was topper. And then it was like I was also given the merit certificate and all that in the college for being the topper. Okay. So it was a great thing to receive that finally in my life. In schools, I have been a topper, but that was predominantly mathematics related. Okay, all my focus was not on biology. Biology record books I used to draw very neatly. Always, everywhere, biology madam was my favorite. They always are very attached to me. But my passion was not to pursue a career in biological line. Okay. So I was mostly into the mathematics. But the mathematics ditched me in my higher secondary. Okay. So okay. I had to wait for the engineering college, which is so far and all that. And finally, like I went into this field and here I got some kind of turning points. I will say mainly the anatomy one. Another professor who is a clinical neurologist, he used to come. I am unfortunate that I forgot his name. Okay. But he is a very, very sensible person. He always cracks jokes. And he makes sure that the worst, the difficult topics, clinical neurology, also he'll make it very lively. He'll take one class every week. Suddenly one day, I was sitting in the last row as usual because of my height. Okay, so I cannot sit in the front, so I sit in the last. That is the biological reason. The psychological reason is it's the most happening place, last row. So sit in the last row and then enjoy the class like, okay, take the class. Okay, like that. And that professor, the physician, he called me like, hey, professor. He called me as professor. Okay. Professor. I was like, oh, shocked. Professor. Huh? We in our college, we used to hear only assistant professor, associate professors. Okay. Associate also was not there. Our principal also was an associate professor only or something like that. Okay. So we never heard the word professor. Professor was like a big respect thing. At the same time, it is sarcastic or funny, something he felt. And he used to always call me, professor, what is your opinion? What is the answer? Professor, what? Huh? What I am telling now, feel as. So I'll be responding with him right from the last row. But one day he saw me in the corridor and he told that, okay, don't think that I am making fun of you. Okay, you will be a professor one day. And your students will admire you. Okay? Like that he said. I don't know what made him to tell like that. Okay? But those are the such words which a teacher tells to a student that really makes a huge difference. I'll tell you, being teachers, all of us, we have our opportunities to blame the students. Okay? We always tell that this is not proper. You have not done that. And people, students who are getting scolded will be getting scolded from all teachers. Okay, you pick them and just appreciate them. Find out the talent what they have. They will have some talent or the other. Just appreciate them. If you do that, you have done justice as a teacher. Because you don't have to teach them. They will learn how to become best. Yes. So like that.
So nowadays teachers are not finding... See, everyone has possessed with some or the other talent. So the teacher's duty is to recognize what is the best potential in a student and then little bit encourage him, and that encouragement create wonders in one's life. So today, whatever you are, so are you giving success to that girl who ditched you, sir?
I see, first of all, although it is individually motivated, okay, later it became a self-motivation. Okay. The success, what happened was, she came back and spoke to me, okay? And then she said that we can be friends, okay? And then in sixth semester and the internship, we were good friends. I know that being a friend is better, okay? Being emotionally involved in terms of all this long-term relationships is not going to help us. It's too young to decide upon that. So best is always go for a healthy relationship, which is socially, which is very constructive one. So I also went on to that. I was happy that at least he spoke to me back. Okay, and then we were good friends. And definitely it was the most memorable part two of my life. But as any boy, you tell that in the mind, it will always be there. In the past, I loved, she rejected, whatever. But still, as a friend, I was very happy to be with her. Okay, close to her and moving around, going around everywhere, all that with all our friends. But that did not make me like that's the end of the journey. Because through that phase, I realized the best of myself. Okay. And I also realized that I should not prove a point to others. Okay. What's most important is, one more incentive was there. Near the third semester, I was telling my mother that I need a bike. Okay. Then my mom told that, if fourth semester, if you are a topper, in all subjects and overall, I will get you a bike. Okay. That was the biomechanics one, fourth one. So it was a blast. I got the biggest marks in distinction, everything for biomechanics. So then I got the bike. So I was very happy that I got the bike. That was very big thing to own a bike those days. A Hero Honda Splendor. So after that, it was like then fifth and sixth, of course, to become a topper, all this. And finally, like... the topper was also just like to prove a point to myself that I am the best. Okay. Because I have realized that I can do something. Whether I can really do it best or not, I wanted to check for myself. But when I did that, it did not come out as any kind of big returns. Okay. From anything. Only from the college a little bit. And after that, everybody is just usual life. And internship, we meet a lot of other college students. Okay, when we are posted in hospitals in Chennai, and we, so our network improved, and through them we came to know that we can apply for Christian Medical College Vellore, the senior internship.
For your internship, sir? Yeah.
Senior internship, which was based upon the exam and also the interview. They take you for 1 year, and then you can do rotation postings in different places with the paid stipend. Okay. So that was like very attractive. Everyone used to think that CMC Vellore, then you can go abroad. Okay? All these things were there. So, went and worked there with my friends. Two, Dr. K.R. Venkatesh and Dr. Mallika. Okay, they are my batchmates. They came with me to CMC Vellore. They also got selected. And we were working there. And Vellore was a big transformation clinically. Okay, like first 2 months, we were seeing patients like the ocean of patients. Okay, every day you will see a lot of cases you are treating. You don't know what to do. You cannot assess adequately because there is too much to do in a little time. And you also don't know because in our BPT, we didn't get any kind of clinical exposure. So,
yes, sir.
Absolutely. Nil.
In the present scenario, whenever you talk about BPT syllabus, after the second year or third year, until and unless we have completed all the 4 years, we are not allowed to touch the patient or to just observe. And it's more of electrotherapeutic approach. So patients, whenever we come into the internship also, whenever treating a patient, they feel like they're a little scared to handle the patients, the present scenario. So were you also the same, or you were treating the patients when you were in a final year or in your third year?
Mine, see, the Tamil Nadu situation is different between government colleges and private. In government colleges, the first year onwards, they are in clinical posting. Okay, they are in the observing and they are doing even treatments. They will do a little bit of ultrasound, the wax therapy, everything they'll be doing. And private colleges which had their hospitals, okay, they also had the students working even from second year, those days itself. But we did not have a inbuilt hospital which is connected to the college. And we had an outpatient unit where hardly 2-3 patients from nearby villages will come. So that usually interns will treat, or in fact, patient themselves will treat and go. Okay, so those are those days those things used to happen. But if you have to actually get the best one, better that the students are there right from first year, I would suggest that it should be parallel. Okay. Yes. In first year, although they don't know the therapeutic thing, at least they can observe the patient in terms of anatomy and physiology. Okay. At least in terms of biomechanics. Whatever they know in theory, they can relate it to the practice. This responsibility should be facilitated by the clinical instructors. Whoever is there in the clinical posting should ensure that first year you don't ask an assessment question or a treatment question. You ask anatomy related question. I am palpating here. Which structures do you think is painful? Okay. We can ask these kind of queries to the first year. And that will be more relevant in their learning.
But that improves the confidence of the therapist also, sir. They also feel, yeah, we have learned that. When we see that same feature, see lateral epicondylitis, when we touch the lateral epicondyle, you can see tenderness. But whenever we see it on the patient, that kind of euphoria what you get, and when you stretch, he says that now I feel better. So that develops the love towards the field. So I always say that love the profession will love you. If you hate the profession will kick you. So, so this is my...
Whenever you think anything as difficult, okay, you think anything as difficult, it is going to make it complicated. Okay?
Yeah.
And because you have created the complication first in your mind. So then when you do it, subconsciously, it will always be making you to make mistakes. Okay?
Yes.
When you think that, you should not think it's too easy also, okay, that will make you to be careless. Only thing is you should be passionate, okay, it's beyond love, that you make an attachment and make sure that you are connected to that, okay, that I should do my best, okay, that responsibility also should be there. Unfortunately, now what is the perspective from teacher's side if you see? First year or second year, if they come to clinical practice, they'll become too much overconfident. They might experiment on the patients, something or the other, whatever they see on YouTube video or they learned in a webinar, for example. Okay, they will start using it immediately in patients. Okay, so we should not allow first and second year. Let them know examination and treatment, then they come to third year, then clinicals. There is also a part of selfishness that... third year, if they come, they can also take the history, they can do some examination, okay? So, it relieves the clinical load, okay, for the teachers. So, that's why they prefer the students in the third and the fourth year. If students come in first and second year, teacher can't leave them and sit in a separate place, okay?
Yes, yes.
Teacher has to be with them. What are they doing? Okay, we have to keep on watching them because they should not experiment on the patients. So... how is their communication with the patient? Everything they have to keep on checking. It's extra load for the teacher who is posted in the clinics. So, but I would still suggest that we should have a mechanism where the same teacher in the college supervises at the clinical practice also. Okay? Because a lot of places children go for clinical postings. But the clinical instructors and the faculty staffs there are totally different from those who are teaching in the college. So, they don't know what exactly was taught. If I have taught PT ortho, if I am in the clinical posting when the students are doing the orthopedic examination on patients, I will be the best person to actually relate theory into reality. Okay?
Yeah.
Otherwise, it will be a huge gap. You can't tell in the college it was taught like that, why you are doing this. You can't ask the clinician. Clinician will say, patient's care is important. We cannot discuss here in front of the patient. Okay, so and in that bargain, what happens is the students just keep observing. They don't know what they are doing, why it is happening. Okay, they just stand. After the posting, the clinician will tell, you can ask me later after we complete the cases. Okay, but most of the time when the clinical load is over, postings of the students also get over early. Every friends will leave. So, you can't wait there to ask a doubt, okay? You have to end up by leaving with your friends or the consultant who is there also might leave early because caseload has reduced, so they might leave. Only the junior staffs will be there in the clinical posting, so they won't be competent enough to answer you. So, ultimately, you get suppressed in your queries that, you know, no need to ask. Okay, all this actually are actually harming our education system, because if we don't promote questioning, if we don't promote an interaction, there is no learning. Okay, and unfortunately we are looking at only the marks, internal marks, the university marks, that everything, but that is not a reflection of success. Okay, we know that lot of people who got very less marks or have been failure during BPT have become best physical therapists. They are owning a chain of clinics where they are appointing other physiotherapists and they are paying very nicely. Okay, we have lot of examples in India here. So career can be coming out from any perspective. That broad aspect the students have to know that. Otherwise, they will feel that we have to only treat the patient. No, if you are not well versed in the communication and in your hands-on skills, you can still be into academics, or go into research, or go into an entrepreneurship. Okay, you just develop an app and then you relate the patient to the therapist. Okay, networking, home care, home visits. Okay, a lot of people have done this, and some of them have started even knowledge resources, even including Physiopedia. Okay, all this you see that it provides a different platform, different scope for you to expand yourself as a professional. And the profession itself is very flexible, it's very dynamic. Today some techniques are there, tomorrow some other techniques are there into the field. Okay, there's a lot of development. Unfortunately, the pace of development of the syllabus is not up to the mark. Okay, that is the unfortunate thing, which I think,
yes, sir, regarding speaking about the syllabus, I have a question. See, on average, every BPT student spends around 3 to 4 lakhs for his education. And they say that BPT is just a basic level education. We cannot give the advanced skills what you require. But when we have to spend a little amount from our own pockets, when we have spent 4 lakhs for our education and spending around some thousand of money to acquire a knowledge, like some attending some workshop or something, there are some individuals who cannot afford that, and they are not able to update the skills actually. That is one thing. And nowadays it has the acquiring business. One individual goes to abroad and learns one skill, and he comes here and he starts it as a like a business kind of a thing. So whether we are leading, this is the right way of imparting the skills to the younger generation of physios. So what is your take on this, sir?
Like for example, you are working in a clinical establishment. You are working in a government institute which is of a global repute. Okay, you are as your job security is much better compared to everybody. Okay, and you can think of experimenting, exploring. Okay, and even what is called as investigating things. Okay, what is happening, what is not happening, why it is like that. But the same person who is working in a private institution, be it clinical or in academic, is always under some kind of pressure. Okay, the pressure from the superiors mainly. Okay, I would say if you get a good mentor as your head of the department, you are the blessed person. Okay, to experiment what you want to teach. Okay, if syllabus change, it's always under the hand of the, if it is a government university, it is the vice chancellors. Okay, the main one. Private universities, it is the principal only who is the in charge. The principal or the dean, who is a physiotherapist, can change the syllabus within seconds. Okay, because they approve that, they tell that this is my new syllabus, this is what we want. Okay, in this subject, these all things have to be taken. Short wave need not be taken. Massage need not be taken. We want high power laser. We want extracorporeal shockwave therapy. Okay, we want pulsed electromagnetic energy. Okay, all these latest developments have to be there if they say that. And the external expert is going to be definitely the friends of the principal. So they are going to approve the new syllabus in the board of studies, and it goes to academic council and it will be integrated. Any change can be implemented by the principal immediately. Okay, in private universities. And to my knowledge, in an approximate estimate, at least 90% of institutions are private in India. We can easily modify the syllabus. Okay, but Do we think syllabus modification is a solution? We have two more challenges. One is the competency of the teachers. Okay, are the teachers adequately trained so that they can teach their students? Well qualified teachers with experience, are they being appointed in the colleges or not? Okay, how many colleges have assistant professors as principal? Find out. Okay, you will find that they are all fresh graduates who are in charge principals. Okay, in many of the colleges, 60% of that 90 who are private are headed by principals who are assistant professors who are just passed out in MPT or they have completed MPT through the distance mode. Okay, they accept a less salary and they don't want extra salary for being the principal. They are happy that they are principal. Okay, so they are heading the institution. You imagine then what will be the academic environment. Okay, when there is no teaching experience, the interaction will be different, the respect will be different. The, for example, from suffering, we all suffered in our life as students. But as a teacher, I do not want my student to suffer. Okay, this is an individual moral responsibility. First one was the rules. The second one is the individual moral one, where you actually see that syllabus, let it be whatever, but I have to teach what is important to the students. Okay, I will teach the syllabus, but after that, beyond that, I will teach what is important and what is the latest developments. Okay, nobody is going to stop me or question me if I teach shortwave diathermy, where continuous and the pulsed mode, the pad electrode, all this disc electrode, all these things, I take lesser time, I finish in 2-3 hours, and I take the pulsed electromagnetic energy for 10 hours. Okay. If I consider pulsed electromagnetic energy is useful, latest evidence, globally it is there, people need to know that, I take it. Who can stop it?
Yeah, sir.
A therapist can teach.
So what I tell is, yeah, if a teacher is determined to give whatever he knows, that is there. But what I'm telling here is, so the teacher is teaching whatever the syllabus which is given, he is getting the salary, the management is happy. But the sufferer is the student here, because he is writing something in the whatever the syllabus, give some important questions, right, pass the university exam. But when he comes out of the BPT, when he is not possessed with great skill, assessment skills, as well as great up-to-date knowledge, and that is like he is into a dilemma that, I have completed my BPT, but I don't know anything. What I gained in the BPT is just a kind of a mark sheet.
Nothing now.
Yeah. So that is what the students are, and then their moral comes down, and then they start and some people will be saying that physiotherapist, and you are and giving some less salaries, and then that kind of a criticism, and then their moral gets down, and they. Majority, if 10 students are passed out, only hardly 2-3 people I see as whenever people passed out as BPT for choosing MPT as their career option, they think is very deeply such that should I go further, they take 100 suggestions, and then they go to hospital administration or to some other field. They are not sticking to the field because they are not finding a career where they can stick to this profession. Only hardly like around some 10-20 people are only continuing here, and they are able to take the career forward in the physiotherapy. But due to this kind of, they see their future to be in the dark, where we don't have any sessions like in the BPT days also. If you take about technology, they have one placement cell. But how many colleges are concerned with the placement of the physiotherapist? No one. So at least
if the placement is happening also, it is also to be, actually it's a darker side of exploitation, where faculty themselves are exploiting their own students. Okay.
Yes.
Faculty might have a clinic, so they want the people to work under them for lesser fees and give them house visits, take percentage from students. Students are going for house visit during their third year and fourth year itself, okay? And they're earning money during the college hours, okay? All these are happening because of lack of proper teachers, okay? I am a teacher. I take responsibility. I see that solution exists within me, or at least it begins from me. Okay? Same way student also should feel from their side what solution they can do.
What I feel is, sir, that we cannot change all the students, all the teachers, sir. But if the student feels that he is paying the fee, and he, if all the students, not a single individual, if single says, they'll try to pressurize him. If all the students, they have to think and they have to represent as a group, then I think that can be, if they present as a group, madam, this has been happening and we want this. And if they can take it to the higher level, I think little can be solved, sir. What do you think about this?
I can understand this perspective, because now what is happening is universities consider the students as consumers, okay, customers. They pay the money to the university, private universities especially, and they give the degree. Okay, we are employees, we are getting the money from the university. So university never listens to the staff, but university always is for student satisfaction. Because the rating of the university is also dependent upon the students. And the government universities, it is the media. If the students protest or anything, it will become a huge thing on the government, the ministry. Okay? So that's the big issue there. So I am not encouraging students to go for protests. But what we can do is, remember, why students don't go for representation? Okay? Why they don't tell? Why a feedback system is there? A teacher, how they are teaching, like that. Okay? Whether they have taught all the topics, whether syllabus is good or not. Every feedback system is there. Nowadays, thanks to the NAC, the UGC inspections periodically, which was happening, that every university has to take the feedback from students also. No student will write a negative point. Not even a single student. Okay? About the teacher or about the course, these subjects can be there, these topics can be there, so that we don't attend a workshop. Most importantly, alumni, the passed out students, are they coming back to the college? Okay? Especially every private university has to hold alumni activities. Okay? The passed out students conducting free workshops for the junior batches on whatever advanced technique they got trained. Okay? This culture is there also. At least it will match during the curriculum that we are getting the same exposure to the techniques which are not in syllabus also. Okay? Yes, but most of the time what happens is students, they pass out. They don't even bother to meet the faculty also and tell that I passed. Okay? They got the result, they ran away. Okay? Wow. Oh, yeah. Okay? Like that. So.
Yeah, sir. That is a great culture which we can imbibe into that. Yeah, we have come up with because when I'm asking, I also self introspection is needed for me, because whether I maybe learned some new techniques, but whether that's a great thing which you have said, sir. Definitely, all the physio friends who are here, definitely, if you have learned any good skill, please impart to your juniors, so that if any person who is not able to undergo that due to some other reasons, it may definitely help him, and you will be helping one individual to establish a life. So please, all the alumni of your respective institutions, please think on this grounds. And sir,
because there is an attachment for everybody. There is an attachment to the college. Okay, whatever they taught us or not, that is a place which actually transformed us. Okay, and senior, junior, there is always a connectivity that I am also from the same college. Okay, you are from 96, I am from 2015, but still, you are from the same college, my senior. Okay, that bonding is there. So you can utilize that, and even college WhatsApp groups are there, together you are there. So organize an event, alumni get together, college get together whenever you are organizing, hold an event. People with expertise, let them share with lectures. Okay, it will not be costly at all. Certificate is needed or not needed, depends upon the resources. Try to upgrade the knowledge of the budding physios, the present students, okay, somehow. But major solution lies with the principal and the teachers. Okay, the good teachers have to be there as principals. If they are principals just because they hold a PhD degree, or they are principals because they accept a lesser salary, they are principals because of recommendation. Okay, if these kind of situations are there, The head of the institution is the actual boss in controlling what is the education system. And the head of the institution should be an inspiring teacher who takes classes timelessly. Okay? Any time you tell the teacher, you should go and take the class. If such a teacher is there, or madam, sir or madam is there, what more you require for the students to develop a role model and they get strongly that passion to the profession? Okay, because that is in the development stage. That is the stage which we should not miss. After passing out, you can't regulate the profession. You can't regulate a clinical physiotherapist. Okay, only way you can regulate is morally when they are coming up as graduate. Okay, so that is done by the teachers. And that's the foundation. If at all some people can change the whole country, Dr. Abdul Kalam said, it is the teacher, school teachers. Okay? Yes. And he said, future of India lies in the school children. Okay? So same way, future of physiotherapy is our physiotherapy students. And that future can be changed only by the teachers. Okay? In the college.
Yes, sir. That okay. is why teachers are given the highest position after the parents. So teachers are the makers of the nation, actually. So, sir, if you look at the teaching pattern, so earlier when you were doing it was blackboard, OHP sheets, and nowadays it has come to a audio-visual world, and now after the lockdown, it has totally changed to webinars. So, nowadays we can see, sir, it projection of the slide and then keep on reading whether the students are following it or not. They are not at all bothered. Their duty is to project the slide and then keep on telling. I feel that the education system is slowly dropping down, or where are we leading to?
No, I already told you. The foundation cost itself, I told you. Good teachers are being rejected from the colleges. Okay? They are not appointed. Senior teachers are not appointed in the colleges. Okay?
And why, if you are a what better is the reason, teacher, sir?
Because senior teacher needs more salary.
More salary. Okay.
People are accepting less salaries. They are because junior faculty is becoming principal. Okay.
But there are strict norms from the university. Like for an associate professor, you need to have some 5 years of experience. It is not
the promotion. It's a responsibility. See, for example, you take a data. We can't talk on the app. Okay, you take a data of all the physiotherapy colleges in India, you check the principals and their qualification. Okay, the principals, all of them will be not professors, they are assistant professors. Assistant professor who is an in-charge principal. Okay, and they are passed out 2-3 years back. This is what I am telling about 90% of the private institutions. So how will an assistant professor will forward a resume for the post of associate for someone else? They will not fill those vacancies.
Yeah.
They will not fill that vacancies.
Oh.
Management also don't want to pay extra money, because you pay 1 lakh for a professor, you can pay 6 people 15,000. 6 lecturers you will get. Why you want 1 person with professor? Okay. Exploitation yeah. begins with our own physical therapist exploiting our own profession. Be it clinical also, those who are employing physiotherapists, they are paying physio, who is appointing a physio only, is paying less. They tell to the hospital that they will accept even if it is 10,000, you don't worry, I will run the department, 1 lakh. Okay? 10 staffs I can have, like that. Don't need to pay them 20,000, like that. They only reduce the salary. And the seniors who go for interview bargain for lesser salary. Okay, I am ready, sir. I will come for 15,000, sir. They tell like this. So the next people, whoever is joining, will get lesser salary than that. Okay, every time seniors are the one who is responsible. Okay, one way as individually how much we are having values. Other way, juniors are not allowing the seniors to join the colleges. Okay, because their post will be gone. They can't be the principal. Okay, so then what quality you expect? When we have learnt from seniors and we know that they have the experience, I'm not telling every experienced senior is the best. But you know that some people have their own credibility, still you don't want to take them. Okay, and later it comes boils down to everyday environment, teaching, interaction, everything. Okay, then it becomes like the teaching skills to take in a blackboard, although it is perceived as old traditional style, okay, teaching in blackboard or OHP, to teach on a blackboard, the teacher has to know more, okay, rather than teaching on a webinar, for example, or in terms of a PowerPoint. Nowadays, we have created a adulteration to such an extent that if somebody teaches on blackboard, he is looked upon like he is an antique specimen. Okay? Why this sir is teaching on blackboard? Okay? We are not able to get anything. We are not able to write. We are not able to listen at the same time. And students ask the teacher, can you give us some notes? Okay? And if PowerPoint also, they feel happy that PowerPoint also, when you put also, students are happy just to copy the PowerPoint, keep on copying. Okay, no brain work. Okay, our webinar means they take the screenshot of the slides. Okay, during the webinar, they feel that, oh, we have taken notes. They never look back at it. Only near the exam, 2-3 months before the exam, they just look at it just to clear the exam. For them, exam is the, evaluation marker that they are good or not. Okay, they are not evaluating themselves in terms of whether I have learnt or not. They are only studying. They are not learning. Okay, yes. And teachers who are many of the incompetent teachers, what they do? It's very easy to take on a PowerPoint. Okay, very easy to show an animated video. Okay, rather than showing on the bone. Okay, having a group of students around you, give them the bones. Or by purchasing a bone is very cheap. Okay, bone set, for example, in anatomy is only 1,000 rupees maximum. 500 rupees for one half. Artificial is now 1,000 rupees. Yes, right. 1,000 rupees is nothing for a student to spend. Okay, they have spent so much. These bones are lifelong. How many students purchase the bones? How many teachers actually teach cadaver? We are talking whether cadaver facility is there or not in the college. But if teacher has knowledge, he can teach with the bones. Okay. He can teach, he can put the muscles in the diagram. I have known faculty who are drawing on the bones to show the muscles. I have myself done the taping from one bone to another bone like muscles. Okay. So that the students will get the idea, made the students to put the tapes. Okay. For the ligament attachment and also for the muscles, all this. Okay. As an activity so that they remember that these are the muscles which are located everywhere like that. But students don't buy those bones. Okay, they don't realize the fact that these are all foundation knowledge and we need it really. Okay, because the teachers are not able to influence them because of their competency problems. Okay, issues. If competent teachers are there, they will modify the instruction style in order to ensure that students will understand and learn, not just study, remember, and then write. Okay, that is not the performance. We have to see that they understand and learn, and they should show it in the patient. Okay, that is when it's actually the performance.
To all the physio friends who have joined our session, sir has rightly pointed out two things which are very, very important. Is you should not study, you should try to learn. So study and learning are two different things, my dear friends. So we have to imbibe that culture of learning, not studying. So thank you, sir, for those wonderful pearls, actually.
Mainly, I will tell differentiators. Studying is you are reading for exam. Okay? Learning is you are reading or understanding for yourself. Okay? Learning is lifelong. Studying ends with the exams. Okay? So, when you think like this and you start opening the book itself, you will remember it even after the exams. Otherwise...
Yeah. I have seen yesterday, sir, being a resource person and a founder of one research article, he was attending one session of Uma Shankar Mahanty, sir, about the shoulder manipulation. So that is the kind of learning attitude which sir has actually. So that is why, that is where we need to learn. Sir, you were attending it, right?
Yeah. Because... Thank you.
Sindhil sir, are you there, sir?
Sir, our time was done actually, so I didn't realize actually it's 1 hour, so we need to, I have only couple of questions actually. Huh, sir, you were saying
because,
you were attending the Uma Shankar Mahanty sir's class. Yeah,
so he was my senior in my manual therapy tutor at Manipal. Now also it's echoing.
Yeah sir. Okay. I don't know, sir. What is the issue actually? Yeah.
Now my voice.
Now it is okay, sir. Yeah, sir. I can.
No, it's
can
back hear. Voice is coming. Back voice is coming.
Okay.
It's fine for me, but unless for the audience. Audience.
Okay. We'll continue, sir. I think I don't know how to fix it actually.
Okay. So because of this. I always looked upon him as a role model. Okay. And other thing is, I had even purchased the sir's books. When he was passing out from Manipal, we were in the first year. We got suggestions. So he has been always a positive role model. And he was a visionary in manual therapy. I will tell characteristic features of Professor Mahanty. He was the person who immediately after passing out, he was working in colleges, but he was not happy. Finally, he realized that I should independently. That's also an example for teachers. That it is like if somebody is pressing you that you should not teach manual therapy to your students. Okay. So if a senior is telling that, okay, they cannot, you cannot teach that.
Hello, sir.
To the student.
Are you able to hear me, sir?
Yeah, I'm able to hear you. This is now better without the echo.
Yeah.
If you connect the
go ahead. Sir.
Headphone is the one. It goes double. Okay. So.
There is some internet connectivity with you. I think yes, sir. Now it's okay. And now then, it's okay there.
Yeah. That is what. So, major thing is to do with, we have to learn from each other. Okay, even sir always has taken positive points from earlier his presentations. I have got the inputs that we can include some kind of jokes or videos in your lectures. Okay, I learned it from sir. And there is always a good thing in everyone which we have to take. And he's been a leader in manual therapy. Mainly in another aspect also that he did not get a certified instructor from any international body. Okay. He is certified by the quality of education what he provides, okay? And his whole batch of students, everyone will be vouching the fact that he is a better instructor than those certified instructors, okay? So, that's the actual inspiration for me. Otherwise, even as you said, I would have also spent lakhs and lakhs to go abroad and get trained, certified instructor, the branding, okay? And naturally, when I spend 4 lakhs or 5 lakhs and I get certified, when I come back, I'll always be like, to get that money back, okay, to get that identity for me. So I will also start conducting workshops at a very high fee. And after that, it will be exploitation of the students again, okay, in workshops and as business, okay. So what way it is we have to promote a healthy knowledge sharing is, main thing is to have an open platform. We should be connected to everybody. Okay. Right from beginning, I was in Orkut. The Orkut was created by Google. And I was there having a lot of communities and having open sharing of knowledge when I was working in Manipal. We had the library subscriptions and things. So I used to have be connected with people there. And after that, through Facebook also, academically, I was promoting knowledge sharing. And also through YouTube, 2009 itself, I had my YouTube channel and I was putting videos. And it's always the connectivity is very important. A student who is in a college should be connected to students in another college also. Okay? And they should share the information along an open platform. This lockdown has provided a huge opportunity that people are able to see other people live, interact with everyone, Insta Live. I'll tell you, going live on Instagram, this is first time for me. Okay? Leave about the interview being a first interview for me. Okay, in my career, after 20 years, as I passed out in 2000 as a physical therapist. Now it's 20 years. Okay? And this is my first interview officially. And you are the first person to take this interview for me. Okay? Of course, interview is usually taken from people who are very big, who are not available otherwise. Okay? So we have to take the interview so that we can get their inputs like that. But I always believe that I am the most connected physical therapist in terms of all my WhatsApp groups and the Facebook profiles, numbers, and I have a lot of friends. So that's the best method to actually share your knowledge, to be connected with everybody, to be open and make sure that you can help everyone. But sometimes life teaches you that you can't do things for free. Okay? When you do it fully for free, ultimately you get exploited. People ask you queries, they expect that you answer them immediately. Okay, any time of the day they keep asking and they want you to answer immediately. Okay, like you become like their assistant or something to give them the knowledge. Okay, they don't see you as a model by which they can promote their knowledge and go higher up. Okay, so this shift in thinking. So now I have become like, okay, we should charge fee for the knowledge sharing. So this is happened last year. So from that time onwards, I have been ensuring that knowledge should reach everybody. And the academy has actually helped in a lot. And all you members and their positive feedbacks, the reviews have helped the academy. And now it's the only academy on with the Facebook page where beyond 5,000 followers, where you have a 5 out of 5 star rating. I really thank all the members and the course participants from Academy of Orthopedic Manual Physical Therapists that this kind of an identity could be given. Okay? Because this is helps in a parallel system. It's not integrated with the curriculum. Okay? However, it helped people to get access to the knowledge. Okay. If you are doing it at an individual level, you get influence from everybody. Okay, that somewhere or the other, the business networks tries to stop you. Okay, or the certified instructors try to stop you. Okay, so you need to have a registered government body so that you can do under your bylaws, you can do what you want to teach. Okay, otherwise, even teachers are under pressure when they teach in the college. It is pressure from their seniors who don't know those techniques. Okay. If a junior faculty is teaching on Mulligan concept, the senior is not knowing anything about Mulligan's concept. Okay. So they will always tell the students that what is the use of learning all these advanced techniques? Okay. You don't know the basics. Without knowing basics, what is the use of learning advanced things? They'll discourage. And they will not allow the students to practice on the patients. They will tell that it will create worsening. They will do the negative feedback to students, to suppress. Beyond that, if a student is again and again coming to the junior faculty and learning, that student will be harassed by the senior faculty. Okay? So, they will be harassed in terms of, you people are big, big experts in third year PPT only. Big, big people are teaching you. Whatever, like that sarcastic comments will go. Okay, these things I faced as a junior faculty, when I was junior faculty. And as a senior faculty when I was, junior faculties are again, those who are in charge principals before my joining. Okay, They were in charge principals. I took over as principal. So they cannot take that. Okay? They know that such a good senior has come, they are ready to teach and everything, but still they want the post. Okay? They want the principal. So the same situation happened, and ultimately you get victimized. You are not matching the system. The system is not matching to your ambitions. So you leave that college, shift to another college. So keep on shifting. And finally you land in a place where someone will understand you. Okay, a good positive environment is there, where other priorities does not matter at all. You should teach what you know. Okay, and even if you don't know, accept, have the morality to accept that I don't know that. Okay, this is important for a teacher. They can't just be with ego that I can't tell the word don't know. Okay, they should tell that I'll go, I'll know it, and I'll come back and I will tell you. Okay, that openly they should tell that. Many of the times teachers are teaching wrong things to students, and they are teaching the wrong things with confidence. Okay, students are misdirected. Students who are intelligent, they will know that what teacher is talking is senseless. Okay, they are not having anywhere to go. There is no platform where students can raise their grievance and anything concrete is going to happen. Be it a private body or it is a government body, even council also, it's not, it cannot influence all these things, because the same issues are there in MBBS and BDS also, same issues are there in nursing also. But ultimately, in what way those professions are stronger and they are getting a social respect is because of individual responsibility. Everyone making sure that I am a nurse, so today if there is a strike, I will not go for work. Okay? If my nursing fellow nurses are getting exploited, I will sit on the road or I will not go for work. Okay? That they maintain. Because of that lobbying, sir, only, they are strong.
There is some problem with your network, sir. I think it's buffering a lot, actually.
You are not able to?
I'm able to hear, sir, but sometimes it is a little break in the voice and it is buffering. Okay, okay.
Is anyone else also telling this comment? Are they not able to hear me? Okay.
No, sir. Now I think it is clear. Sir, now many of the young.
The host internet connectivity is main thing.
Sir.
Okay. You are the host.
Yeah, yeah.
You are going live. So,
yeah, sir. We have a couple of people here. One is, I think she is your student, Ritu, and Pooja Digra. These two people, are since the live session has started, I think they are your not number one fans. They are your zero. Means they are more front of the one, actually. They are your hardcore fans, sir. Please. Would you like to tell them anything, Ritu and Pooja Digra? And they also said that you are the legend of physiotherapy.
No, to say that I am a legend of physiotherapy, okay, they need not be my students. Okay, anyone who is passionate to physiotherapy profession will know the fact of who's doing a great work, and it's their greatness. See, if you wear an orange glasses, the whole world appears orange. Okay?
Yeah, yeah.
So if you are having the greatness within you, you will recognize the greatness of everyone around you. So they are great, passionate physical therapists, so that they can recognize the greatness. So people appreciate others. And that's the same spirit by which you felt that you should have the interview with me. Okay? So...
Yeah, sir.
Although... You attended the workshop years before as a student in Hyderabad.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay? But yeah, still you yeah. felt that, you know, I don't know what made you to wait for so many years, but still this is the moment. And today I'll tell you the special thing is also, tomorrow is my birthday. Okay?
Oh.
The 10th August. So coincidentally, you did not know this, but it's become a gift in advance for me. Okay? So it's a great milestone for me, first interview. I don't know however it went because of the connectivity in the technicalities and all this. Really, it's a very, really very memorable.
We are blessed to have you, and advance birthday wishes to you, sir. And sir, one thing is, now the younger generation of physios, when they come out, and then other multi-specialty branches like doctors, they say that you people are paramedics and you cannot suffix doctor, you have to prefix PT. So what you would like to tell the younger generation of physios, sir? Is it really matters that you should have a doctor in front of you, or there are some regulatory bodies which have given their stand that you can publish doctor, but always there is an this fight happens actually between the other professions and physiotherapists. So what do you suggest the younger generation of physios, sir, from your side?
As an individual, you prefix doctor, okay? No one can tell you that you are a quack, okay? But identify yourself as a physiotherapist. In the board, you put the doctor, you put PT, and you put physiotherapist below that. There is absolutely no problem, okay? And your area, clinical area, identify itself as a center, physiotherapy center. Don't put the name clinic, okay? If you put the name clinic and you are putting doctor, it is going to actually clash with the policies of the government, where they might identify you as a quack, okay? If you are putting that you are a physiotherapy and rehabilitation center and you are putting doctor in your name, it is not going to create a problem, okay? But if you put a physiotherapy clinic and then you put doctor, clinic and doctor, you come under the Clinical Establishment Act, okay? So where you need to be under a registered medical practitioner, okay? You should be a registered medical practitioner, where we don't come under that category at all. So unnecessarily legal troubles will spoil your peace of mind, okay? And patients never hesitate to call you as a doctor. Moment you are as a professional, not as a technician. Difference is, technicians give the treatment directly. If you are doing that, patients only will question why you are prefixing doctor, okay? If you are assessing them, you are explaining them, you are also listening to them, okay? Definitely they will themselves will call you doctor, okay? And especially girls, the women physios who are practicing, patients will call them madam. I think yeah, so yours is streaming, okay? Your video one was streaming when I was going live. Your internet connectivity is the main thing that is fluctuating in between.
How does sir?
Dr. Srinivas, yes, you are back now. Mm. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, sir, now it is clear, yeah.
Okay, so what way we can do a better change from here? Okay, the solutions, that is most important. Everybody should take individual responsibility. That is most important. A teacher should take the individual responsibility, okay? And students should take the individual responsibility. The transformation comes from within, okay? And if you are not building up,
okay,
it's going to be a huge challenge.
Sir,
we can't fight the other profession when we are not actually united. We are fighting among ourselves,
yeah.
Okay? Then how can we handle the external challenges, okay? And when it comes to institution, you have to follow the rules of the institution, okay? You can't be like in a hospital when you are there, or the medical college is affiliated with the hospital. MCI is there. Okay, for them, doctor is only for these all professions. So it clearly states. So they will not allow you to prefix doctor. Okay, even if you are a PhD, the colleges will not allow you to prefix doctors. Okay, they will tell that it is only for the medical one, because the university is a medical university, medical college is there, and physiotherapy college is also there. They will not allow you to do that. So That is as per their regulatory body, because in order to keep a specific identity so that patients don't confuse. But individually, don't go into any clash with the medicos. Okay, I will tell you the fact that we are a branch of medicine. Okay, branch cannot fight with the root. Okay, we should understand that branch should learn from the roots. Branch should learn from the stem. Okay, we should see that from the mainstream physicians, we should learn and we should interact with them more and more in a submissive manner, because they were much more senior to us. They were so many years. Okay, we should have a healthy relationship, and we should not project that physiotherapy grows means patients need not see the physician. Okay, these kind of marketing words we should never use, because it is not true. Because there are many, many, many problems where patients need physicians also. Okay, and physicians also know that for every problem we need a physiotherapy. Okay, we need to work together. You see, it's not whether physiotherapy is better or physician medicine is better. Patient has to be better. Okay, for the patient has to be better. Both needs to work. There is a commercially targeted physical therapist also, and commercialized physicians also. Okay, for everything they order investigations and surgery. Okay, they don't refer for physiotherapy. That extreme is there. But there are good physicians also, good clinicians also. Patients know who is best. Okay, you need not talk negative things about a physician to a patient. Okay, ultimately the clinician, the medico will know about that you are negatively propagating. So they will try to inhibit you. Okay, develop a better direct stream of communication. Even if a physician is junior to you by age, respect them for their degree, that they have medicine, which is the mother profession, and physiotherapy grew from medicine. Okay, so accept that fact, and we should be trying to explain that we have these all options. If a physician is suggesting a particular treatment, give the treatment. Okay, but in show that 2 days the patient is not improving. Okay, if the patient improves, no problem, just be quiet, no problem, referral based practice, still you give it. Patient not improving, that time you go and discuss. Patient has advanced goals, functional goals, go and discuss to the clinicians, ask them that can I add the new treatments which I am trained, I can use it. If you want to be, when you are free, I will show that, sir, you tell me your opinion, how I can best treat, I can treat the patient in front of you. Options, you only give that. Show that sincerity that you want to improve the patient, not like you want to show off your techniques. Okay, then the physician will be definitely concerned. They will tell that, yeah, no problem, you are confident now, okay, you do it. Okay, they will tell, just to keep in touch with me how the patient is feeling. Okay, they will tell. So maintain the communication. That is the basic thing which will stop the interprofessional clash, because it is not going to help physios at all. Okay, even if a central council is formed at any stage, we are going to have physicians heading there. Okay, because physiotherapy is a system of medicine. Okay, so when it comes under that, medical professionals will be heading there. How are you going to get the better out of that council or anybody if you are not having a good understanding or relationship with the medicos? Okay, so don't be like stigmatized for independent. In that term, don't be developing your ego. Okay, we should have self-confidence, we should have self-integrity, but we should also ensure that everybody understands our goals, and we all work together to betterment of the patients. See, ultimately, who is the majority? How many number of physios are there? How many number of medicos are there? Okay, physicians are there. But more than these two, majority is patient. So if we are public oriented, we help in disaster management. Okay, anytime we are ready to help the public. When you are walking and going, if there is an accident, how many physios will go and do the first aid immediately? Okay, there the public will recognize that the doctor was there that time. Okay, resuscitation techniques, are we knowing that? Okay, whether it has to come in curriculum, by the syllabus through the principals, or it is the teacher who is teaching out of their own wish. Many people are taking free workshops on basic life support, and they have trained people also under the Red Cross also. So make sure that you are adequately trained. Identify yourself as you are for the public, you are for humanity, so that patients will recognize you and they will give the stamp that they are doctors. Okay, when we have patient support, even future if there are any lobbying needed also, public support is needed. We tweet anything in Twitter, if public support is there, the retweeting is more, media attention will come. Okay, automatically the press will also publish that. The more the views, the TRP for a channel, anything and everything, it is the public lobbying that is important. So we have to be worried about the patients more and get the lobbying there. There in front of them, what image are we projecting? In social media, we should stop fighting with each other. Okay, that is not at all a situation where it is going to get any kind of respect. Okay, we start barking at each other, both of us will be treated as dogs. Okay, ultimately, but dogs are very good animals. They are the best animals companion for human beings. But remember that we should not be treated like street dogs. Okay, we should be treated like breed dogs. Okay, so that way we'll get the respect only if we maintain the dignity and we defend all our professionals as myself. Okay, be it they are a physician or be it fellow physiotherapist, I should maintain the dignity in front of patient. I should not let another physiotherapist down. Okay, I should not talk negative about my profession. To my juniors also, I should not tell negative things about my profession. If I am telling negative things as a problem, I should also suggest a solution. Okay, with the solution I should talk, then you are paving for positivity, problem solving and way ahead. If you are talking only the problem and telling that this is not there, that is not there, that is not there, juniors will get losing the morale, and students will feel that what I am going to do for NPT, okay, whether I have to work as ortho or cardio, okay, whether I have to work or I have to study, they don't know anything like this. Why they are confused? Because negativity is put into them. If negativity not there, they know that if they are hungry, they know they want to eat fried rice or they want to eat biryani. Okay, everybody knows this, individual choice. Then why are you not having a choice for ortho or neuro or cardio? You should have the choice. Students should have the choice. They should not ask others what is better, what is better. Another person tells it is better because it is better for them, not for you. Okay, we should have that individual thing. And role model teachers, these are very important, because unless we sort this issue out in colleges, the foundation of building an image as a physiotherapist for students, the morality can be done only by the teachers. Okay, after that in practice it will continue, it will transform by self responsibility. And research is another dimension where everybody is maximally taking shortcuts. They want publication. Okay, however and however they get publication, they put it as like we got a publication. You check the journal, 2500 they take, they publish whatever that is sent. Okay, those kind of journals, what is the point in publishing? Okay, many physiotherapists are sharing in Facebook that we got a publication, I am a peer reviewer. Okay, which journal you are peer reviewer? What is the big deal of being a peer reviewer? Are you an editor? Are you a editorial board member of a journal which is indexed in impact factor journals? That is credit, not journals which do business, which take the money and they publish. Okay, this false propaganda is there, that to promote the self image lot of people are doing, and unregistered academies and societies are conducting courses. Okay, everybody is a resource person. Okay, it is like you attend yesterday, today you become a resource person. Okay, so what way you are a resource person? Even students are taking webinars, they are taking as a resource person, other people are attending. Knowledge everybody can spread, there is no problem at all. Okay, but you cannot underestimate a person who has a knowledge, a real knowledge. Okay, learning from them who are sharing knowledge for the purpose of sharing, not for the money. Okay, these kind of people you should identify. A people is an achiever. A person is an achiever only if Google endorses them. Okay, with so many pages links about the person. Okay, so we should identify who are the people who are like that, and then learn from them. Those who are really openly willing to teach are not through YouTube videos or open platform. Are they sharing the knowledge or not? Okay. Otherwise, if they are not sharing the knowledge through YouTube videos, not sharing in live platforms, they are simply coming only in paid webinar. Don't attend their courses. Boycott. Okay. Just because your friend is telling they are good, don't attend. Because they are telling it is good because they are getting paid for sending candidates. Okay. So your friend will tell, extraordinary teacher, you attend. Webinar, 2 hours, 3,000 rupees. Okay, fee. How come they can charge like this? Okay. That has to come where every student is actually stronger. They are the major, if I am telling clinical regulation means it has to come through patients. Okay. They will identify that he is a good, he is a quack. Okay. He is a qualified physiotherapist. He is assessing me and treating. Another person, no assessment, just giving treatment, having attractive clinic. Young girls are sitting as receptionists to put everything and then smile and say that, sir, you take the package, sir. Okay. Immediately these people take that therapy. Who are they? They are not physiotherapists, those girls. Some physiotherapy girls also getting exploited like that in these kind of underqualified physio clinics. They have a degree, proper degree, but they don't know anything. Okay, they don't know how to evaluate, they don't know how to treat. They are just passed out from colleges and they have got ABCD behind their name, certified practitioner, all these things, instructor things, and they just want to do business. Okay, how to stop that? Patient. Okay, reach the patients through television channels, reach the patients through camps. Okay, show them that physiotherapy has assessment. Show your assessment skill on the television, okay, live. Have the confidence that you can treat a patient when the channel is live, okay, and then create a revolution. Patients, everybody will realize that the other person is just a fake person, okay. They will stop going there. That is the long-term solution. Tomorrow, if we are again in an open platform, if we are lobbying also, public support is needed. Then only government will listen to us. Okay? Because number of votes, 5 lakh people are viewing this, media attention, then votes, it is important. Then the government will be forced to create any change in the council, existing council also. Okay? So try to get the public
sir,
support.
As a founder of AOMPT, so if students are really willing to learn this manual therapeutic skills, because everyone is afraid of doing spinal manipulations and everything, and but they are having some financial problems which they cannot afford or something. So as a part of AMOPT or AMPT, are there any perks or any sponsoring for those kind of students who are really talented? They have their merit, but due to some financial constraints, they are not able to update. They can approach you, sir.
Last year when I started the membership of AYMPT, okay, in August, okay, same time I started this, initially the membership itself was free, okay, till August 31, whoever was contacting me was getting free membership with 3 courses, videos, okay, YouTube links, they all were getting free like that. And periodically every time I used to announce that a particular date, you will get free memberships. Same way tomorrow, I have already announced, okay, that people can contact me and they get free memberships like that. Also, the newly designed AOMPT website has 4 online courses free. Okay, so you can register through the website and send me, contact me in my WhatsApp. So they will get the free courses, the videos. Okay, which is Introduction to Manual Therapy, which establishes all the 10 concepts. That is free. Another is Arthro-Manual Therapy, which is articular techniques, joint-based techniques. Myo-Manual Therapy, which is myofacial techniques. And Neuro-Manual Therapy, which is neural mobilization and neurodynamics. All the 4. And the 5th one, AM and MT, Arthro-Myo-Neuro-Manual Therapy, which is a signature technique. All these 4 techniques, Arthro-Manual Therapy, Myo-Manual Therapy, and Neuro-Manual Therapy, and arthromyo neuromanual therapy are registered approaches of AYMPT. I am going to give all these teaching videos, YouTube links of directly my workshop techniques, demonstration techniques, free. So people can get access to this. And remember that it is like scholarships, merit-based scholarships was there last year. Okay, I was giving for people who have beyond 75% free, and beyond 60% it is 25% discount in the membership fee. And I was giving depending upon the percentage. Okay, so till 50% fee discounts and all that. I was keeping around 300 for students. Okay, 300 rupees with the teaching videos, with membership. Okay, that's the full fee. In that you get. Dr. Srinivas internet. Yeah, we have this affiliate program where people who are not having financial backgrounds, okay, have high merit, definitely they will get the membership, okay, discounted ones. If they want it to be totally free, they should enroll more members to the academy, okay, get the knowledge more spreading, then they get a free courses. Any course is free for anybody if they enroll 10 people who are able to pay the fee. Okay, so that is your network, your connectivity. So it is like you get 10 students to know about the academy and they are enrolling for the courses, your course, that course becomes free for you totally. Okay, so you have learnt it, you can know from the free videos how much you are learning. Okay, and you know what kind of teacher is teaching in AOMPT. So that means you should definitely work for the goodness. Everybody should learn that. Okay, so when you are working towards that, you get the scholarship automatically. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you for announcing those things. And if all our physio friends who are interested, definitely they can log in through the website, AOMPT website, as well as we have launched an app. So these are the two things which you can get connected to the page. And please do subscribe Sir's page on Instagram as well as FB and on the YouTube. And so I think, and I thank Sir for coming onto this Physio Conversations as the guest of the week. So we'll be having this kind of sessions with all the young physios who share as their how and how they have come up in life and their experiences, which we can learn and imbibe those skills as well as those knowledge. And thank you, sir, for sharing that. And that's all for today. So stay tuned for the next week. Thank you, sir. Would you like to tell anything to the younger generation of physio, sir?
Yeah, this what is usually I didn't know that how long it will be this session. Okay, you just said that it is 5 p.m. We didn't know that whether it is 5 to 6 or 5 to 7. I am never believing on any ending, but every ending should be a good beginning. Okay? It should be a good platform for the future to build. I hope this session enlightened people, whoever was watching live, the few people who were live. Okay, but this session's link or anything can go, whether it could be shared with everybody. Okay, through otherwise people who are busy with their work, they can watch later through your channel. Okay, from the Instagram yours, and also
yes,
we will also put this, if it is possible, as a recording that we can put it so that people can watch it later.
Yes, sir. In this video, the previous video and this video is in the IGTV, so they can watch it, and if possible we'll try to save this if possible and then share it in the YouTube.
Okay, it is where it is live, it is IGTV. What is that?
IGTV. So we have, whatever the video is recorded here will be posted in the IGTV, and which can we can post it on the page actually.
Okay, I didn't know about IGTV. What is IGTV?
This is Instagram TV, sir.
Okay. Okay. So basically, I have to thank God that He has created people like you. Okay. To feel that you should interview and take my inputs, know my early phases of my life, which I actually shared with people during webinar participants sometimes or the other. But today gave me a better opportunity, and it came through you. And so I wish all the good luck in all your efforts. what you want to build a better future for physiotherapy through connecting with people. I really appreciate your efforts and wish you very good luck. And also the people who have watched this session live, okay, God bless you all. And keep rocking and never lose your positivity. It's not worth it. Okay. And the next thing, you don't have any right to spread negativity. Okay. As a human being itself, generally itself, you don't have any right to spread negativity. So stop doing that. Okay. If you are talking ill about your own physiotherapy profession, that means you are questioning the character of your own mother. Okay. So it is same like that. So please don't do that. Okay. Whether it is in social media, public platform, or in the WhatsApp groups, do not talk negative things about your profession. Okay. This is very, very important for any profession. And also for developing profession like physiotherapy, we need people to work with positivity. Okay. And we should respect each other. We should suggest each other improvements. We should learn from each other. And we all should work with each other. It's not working for other person. Okay. You are working with other person. Okay. We should think like that. Students are our future colleagues. Okay. And we should remember that. We should give them the best direction as teachers. Okay. So as a teacher to another, all the teachers in physiotherapy profession, it's my appeal that upgrade your skills first. Okay. If, for example, Dr. Pooja Digra, she's a teacher. Okay. She was my student earlier. That is a different issue. But she's a teacher now. She's still learning. So it will help her students. Okay. So that's the way teachers should feel that obligation, that we should actually upgrade our skills and then teach our students. Don't stick to the papers. Syllabus is only the basic requirement. Syllabus is not the limit. Okay. Don't take the syllabus as a limit, upper limit. Syllabus is a lower level of requirement. Beyond the syllabus, whatever you teach, nobody can stop you. Okay. You don't think that syllabus is the end of it. Okay. Syllabus is just the beginning. So that should come from the teachers. And students, my appeal is, please respect the teachers who are sincere. Okay. Most of the time, students respect the teachers who are threatening. Those who are speaking about marks and exam. Okay. Those teachers only get respect. Those who are really teaching well, morally they respect, but on direct reality, they don't encourage those teachers. Okay. If that teacher comes, sincere teacher comes, students just run away because they are asking for ID card, they are asking for apron, they are asking for shoe. Okay. Because sincere teachers bother about discipline. Why they are bothered about discipline? Because students are the future image for the profession. Students wear the apron and ID card and they go to the shops nearby, they smoke with the apron and ID cards. The shopkeeper will think that physiotherapy students, they are like that only. Okay. Tomorrow when the shopkeeper comes for treatment, he will not respect a physiotherapist. He will call that sister. Okay. He will not call doctor. So how we maintain in front of public only gets the respect. And the same time, it's your responsibility to encourage a good teacher. You cannot allow good teachers to get frustrated. Okay. Because the junior faculty who are teaching really very good, they'll be suppressed by the senior faculty. At least the students should support them. Students should actually be with them because they are doing good. Every student knows among the teachers who is really teaching and who is showing off, who is threatening. Okay? Threatening people should be exposed. Okay? They should be, you complain also, you take action also. Whatever it is, do not allow any kind of harassment. Okay? And don't change your nature to learn. Okay. Questioning if somebody is not allowing means go to the principal. If principal is not allowing means you should fight. Somebody has to bell the cat. Okay. Some generation has to take the change, the responsibility and do it. Okay. Otherwise it is like good teachers will lose their motivation and students also, those who are really sincere students will be made fun by the other students. They'll be isolated by the other students. Okay. Sincere students will be feeling lonely, okay? And ultimately, they will stop questioning because batchmates don't want to delay the class, okay? They want to complete faster and they want to go, okay? So, lot of peer pressure is there. So, you have to overcome all this and build up a strong future. It is all individual transformation and individual responsibility, okay? everybody should respect another person also as yourself. You should respect. Okay, this should come. I respect Dr. Srinivas not because Dr. Srinivas is taking my interview. It's because he is physiotherapist. I respect physiotherapy, so every physiotherapist I will respect. This should come. Okay, if this comes,
yeah,
then
so
in future physiotherapy profession will get the respect. Okay, that is the take home message. So, and I'll conclude now. Okay, and I know you are waiting.
Thank you for coming.
Okay. So, yeah. See you. Keep up your good work. God bless you. And
thank you, sir.
Stay careful. Stay rocking.
So, yeah, sir. So stay positive, respect everyone, and proud to be a physio. Love your profession, and definitely the future days are ours. And thank you, and stay rocking. And this is Srinivas Naik, physio for all and all for physio. Thank you for joining for today's session, and bye. Yes, sir.
Proud to be a physio. Okay, you feel proud when you can make another physio. Okay. Become the best. When you help other physios to become the best, then you feel proud. Okay, as a physio. Okay, so don't feel proud without knowing anything. Okay, you can't be a proud physio without any knowledge. Don't be having the false pride. Okay, and remember that you should have the logic or the rationale behind that. I am a proud physio. Why? Because I know some things. I can make the difference on the patients. I can create a better future for my juniors. Okay, I can be a better team member when I'm working with others. Then you feel proud. Okay, so that should be the thing, and that's the meaning of the true meaning, which I would like to highlight to students especially, because whenever we say I am proud to be a physiotherapist, trust me, I am a physiotherapist. Okay, all these things, these quotations are very attractive. They are using it. But are the students thinking that? Do we know the knowledge for that? Do we have the knowledge for that? Work upon that. Don't feel bad that you don't have knowledge. Feel good that you have resources from where you can grow your knowledge. Work upon that to grow your knowledge. Okay, that is important. That is solution oriented.
And so you yourself should know. You need not tell it to anyone. You yourself should know that what you are capable of and what are your strengths, and then work on yourself, and definitely you will be proud and always be. Tell a good thing about yourself, and be think good about yourself, and be good, and good will happen to you. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Good luck.